Hi, this is Bitluni and today we check out if the ESP32 cam could be used as a time-lapse camera. Now that I'm playing around with these cheap ESP32 cameras, I wanted to try out all the obvious quick projects you could do with them. Last week I covered an easy way to program the camera using my board. I didn't expect such a great resonance. The few boards I prepared were immediately sold out. But no worries, restock should arrive any day soon if it isn't yet. But back to today's project. If you got one of these, you immediately spotted the SD card slot. This is perfect for storing images and probably even video recordings permanently. Since I also do some gardening projects, I immediately thought of creating a small and cheap time-lapse camera to get some cool recordings of my plants growing. I like to do time lapses from time to time, but never over a longer period of time since I need my main camera for the channel and wouldn't leave any valuable hardware out in the weather. So to turn this into a simple time-lapse camera, I only need to take pictures at a configurable time interval and store them onto the SD card. Taking the images is straightforward. I have done this already for my LED wall. I just need to check one of the libraries accessing SD cards. SDMMC seems to work fine. But there is yet another facepalm moment with these modules. Either I get something wrong or it appears that the LED flash is sharing a data pin with the SD card interface. So it flashes every time you access the SD card. This makes it useless for continuous recordings unless you cover the LED. However, it's not a showstopper. There still is an important aspect about time lapses to be aware of. When the light conditions change during your recording span, the automatic exposure, white balance and focus of the cameras will mess up your recording. The automatic adjust will appear as a jump whenever it kicks in. Oscillations are even worse. The ESP32 camera API provides an interface to control all the aspects except the focus. The camera is fixed focus. The camera example sketch provides a nice web interface to configure everything. I thought I could use that example as a starting point, remove unnecessary features, and add the features needed for the time-lapse recording. If you do that, you need to pick the AI Thinker ping configuration for these modules and also select the Rover module and large app to be able to get it running. In a hacker session, I modified everything.
Hacker mode activated.
Now I can use the interface to get a preview from the camera, set the interval, and simply start a time-lapse. This will automatically create a new timelapse folder and store each frame as a JPEG. The timelapse will stop either from the interface or when the card is full. The JPEG images can be converted to a video using the open source FFmpeg tool. I link to the project page below for all the details and the latest code. You can try to improve the image quality using this slider. Lower is better, but at some point the JPEG, especially at higher resolutions, won't fit into memory anymore and the ESP will crash. Let's take a look at some results I got from 2 days of testing. You immediately see it's not very suitable for macro shots since it's out of focus at close distance. This is about half a meter away. The plants are clearly alive. Let's check out some landscapes. Okay, the image quality is as expected from a sub $6 camera, but the price might justify it if you like to run multiple recordings for a long time. But I also have to admit that old cameras or even phones might do a better job if you actually want to use the footage for a video. I hope you liked that quick and dirty project, and I see you next time. Bye!